night we met. Guys, it's so great to have you in studio, and congratulations, it's such a lovely Christmas number, isn't it?
And they're nearly singing along with it. I wish everyone could hear you during that.
I have to say, you made us all melt. The voices are so beautiful, absolutely. But guys, Liam Payne, tell us about that. Codalan already wrote you a song, and now Liam Payne. Kian, I'll go to you. Did you ever think that a member of 1D was going to write you a song?
No, the lads would probably say I'm probably the biggest fan as well of One Direction.
So
so to hear that, when we got wind that it was written by One Direction, written by Liam Payne, and you know that we were going to be able to record it, we were just over the moon, and we were just delighted once we got in. The song actually worked for us and really fitted our sound. So.
And can I ask him, just as a fan, were you disappointed when Zayn left?
Yeah.
Zayn, yeah, I suppose I was, you know, because you know that's what One Direction were. But you know, the four lads were well able to, you know, they released the album there week before last, and that's amazing as well, so they were still able to do it.
Yeah.
It's really interesting, I think, what Louis Walsh says about you guys in particular, that how well you gel and that you're less work than girls. Like, does it all happen quite organically with all of you? Or like, how did you suddenly go, right lads, we have to have loads of chemistry?
Well, no, see, we met like over a year and a half ago in a hotel, and Louis was just like, Eric, get in there and get along with each other. So
do you think is kind of the unifying factor? Is it the passion and the drive, and you guys just want to do well, and this is plan A, there's no plan B?
I think there's like a natural chemistry. It just naturally happened. Louis did put us together and basically put us into a room together. It was like, get along.
And
then he didn't even have to say that, and we have a laugh. Everything's a laugh. Like, no matter what. You see, when we're not on this, we're all just giggling. Like, we get.
You know, you should be told to shut up and be quiet.
You get the fit of the giggles quite regularly, don't you?
All the time.
But come here, tell us about Vicar Street, because you sold out, and as a result, you put on another date, the 5th of December, is it?
4th. Yeah, Louis, after we done the last one, Louis was like, guys, you gotta go in again. I was like, yeah, okay, Louis, whatever you say.
It's a good impression.
Yeah,
I went to do it, but I said he might see this and then kill me. So, but yeah, 4th of December, we're dying to get back in. It's going to be kind of like a Christmas special.
Okay, fantastic. We look forward to that. And lads, were you living in London at one stage, or you're just back and forth? Yeah, Kian.
Yeah, we were. We were in London for a solid 3 months, and it was pretty. It was very busy, but you know, we did have time in the apartment, and you know, the apartment did get pretty messy. You know, there'd be rotten bananas left around, and then there'd be dishes and. Also, it's poor Ryan and Brendan were sleeping on the couch for the 3 months.
So that now.
Any of you good cooks or cleaners amongst you?
Obviously, one of the
King and Josh.
Anyway.
And are you the baby? Yeah.
He asked me every night, do I want stir fried?
I was bought like too much food, and I was like, lads, anyone wants it, might be like Google recipes and just cooking away to myself.
Do you want to come over to my
house? He makes a great stir fry, honestly. Top notch.
Dale, tell me, what do your friends and family think now? Because it's probably kind of, you know, pretty normal, you guys, you know, being on TV and hearing the songs on the radio. How have they reacted to
that? They're all very, very supportive, like, and you know, they know this is what we want to do and we love doing this, so they're all just like, they're all behind us and they're all very supportive.
What about personal lives? Partners?
Nobody loves
it. Hometown fans won't allow you, will they?
No. They won't let us. I'll show your work.
Is he good that, like, does he kind of rein you in? Like, seriously, do you watch other boy bands and go, okay, we're not going to do that? Or, you know, how much you kind of look and learn about the industry and go, right, that's not for us?
He's a hard taskmaster. He is. He knows himself, like, but he's very critical of us, but constructively. He knows the rights and wrongs in the music industry, so we listen to him because he's had success before.
Yeah.
And so far he's not led us wrong, so we're full trust in him.
And lads, tell us, what are the highlights, if you could go?
The trip to South Africa where we recorded
Where
It Belongs and Cry for Help, and that week there was just, you know, we want to go back, I want to move there.
We landed there with a full day off the first day we got there, so that was crazy. Like,
last day we had some time off as well. He's just lay out the sun, burnt a bit.
Oh, stop. So they're talking about days off. I know.
Show us how busy our year is.
Yeah. Is the album out right now?
Yeah, it is right now.
Amazing. And tell us what your fans can expect.
I think there's a good mixture of songs, you know, there's a couple of kind of more ballady songs that are good. Maybe there's one song, Roses, that is great. I think it'd be great for Christmas now at the moment. And Then there's some other tunes that I think we'll still be able to play next summer, so I think it's one for
great.
To go in the collection.
We're going to have to ask some fan questions.
Yeah, I know, I can see Karen here, Karen.
Yeah, it's not my question.
We want to know about your Bickerstreet gig on the 4th. Mm-hmm. Is there any surprises in store?
There is
a surprise. I have to give them a little teaser.
No, you can't.
There's something festive.
Santa
coming?
I hope.
Just
got to dress Louis up as Santa.
Brilliant.
Ideal. Yeah. Shauna wants to know, what is it like having girls chase your van?
It happened in Cork there the weekend on the street. They were banging the van. Our driver was giving out that his car was dented and everything, but
it kind of felt like The Walking Dead.
Except our fans are not zombies.
Of course not. We have another one from Zoe. She wants to know, who's the most annoying amongst you?
Depends on the day.
Right. Is there ever any fights?
Dale never points them.
Okay.
But it's not annoying. Yeah. Unless you're tired or something like that.
That's funny.
Okay. Generally, we don't tend to get annoyed at each other much. Yeah.
Okay, well, that's good. I hope you keep it up.
We have a treat now because you are actually going to sing for us. What are you going to sing?
I thought you were going to say you had a treat for us.
No, we're going to sing a little chorus a cappella of our new single, The Night We Met. Well, so if we can just
get your tone, yeah, good amount. I love it as well.
Got it.
Good luck.
Out of run to you, but there's no room left. I gotta give a step, but I'm out of breath. I wanna kiss your lips like I did back then. So take me back to the night we met. I wanna mend your heart if it's not too late. I'm gonna say the things that I couldn't say. And if I die tomorrow with nothing left, the best thing I ever had.
Wow, guys, that's fantastic.
Oh my God. I think we've got our next six guest presenters, Glenda. Lads, you've been an absolute pleasure to have in the studio. Thank you so much.
And best of luck with everything, lads.
Yes, the album and, of course, the Bickerstreet gig. Great to have you. Thank you so much. All right. All right, while we recover, it's time.